Good evening, everyone. Myself, Dr. Ashwini, second year postgraduate in the Department of Radiodiagnosis in Arupadevidi Medical College and Hospital, Puducherry. My title for today's paper presentation is A Case Report on Tuberculous Retroperitoneal Abscess. Introduction. Tuberculosis is an airborne infectious disease caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and it is a major cause of morbidity and mortality, particularly in developing countries like India. Extrapulmonary tuberculosis represents approximately 15% of all tuberculosis infection. Abdominal tuberculosis can involve the entire gastrointestinal tract, including the peritoneum and pancreatobiliary system. However, there are no pathognomic imaging findings, so the diagnosis ultimately rests on histopathological and microbiological confirmation. Case report. A 57-year-old female was admitted with the complaints of right upper abdominal and right flank pain with fever. The patient was a known case of type 2 diabetes mellitus and was on treatment with insulin for 15 years with a poor glycemic control. There was no history of previous tuberculosis exposure. Then laboratory investigations. Laboratory results revealed an increased erythrocyte sedimentation rate and increased C-reactive protein. And the patient had leukocytosis with a total count of around 13,500 with 86% neutrophils and 14% lymphocytes. The patient also had mild anemia with hemoglobin of around 8.9 grams per deciliter, whereas liver function test, renal function test, and blood urea nitrogen were within normal limits. And blood culture for aerobic and anaerobic bacteria did not produce any significant growth. Chest radiograph was taken and it was normal. Radiological findings. In ultrasound, there was a fairly defined collection in the right flank region with internal echogenic contents, and there was evidence of peripheral vascularity on color Doppler. These are the series of coronal contrast enhanced CT images showing a large heterogeneous collection in the right perirenal and pararenal spaces with evidence of surrounding fat standing. These are the series of axial contrast enhanced CT image showing a large heterogeneous collection in the right perirenal and pararenal retroperitoneal spaces, and the collection is seen confined to the retroperitoneal space with no evidence of bone erosion or bony invasion. Ultrasound guided percutaneous aspiration was done. It yielded a mucinous fluid which was not sufficient for microbacteriological examination. Then exploratory laparotomy was performed. It revealed a large retroperitoneal yellowish mass containing a pus. The histopathological examination of the surgical specimen showed a epithelioid granulomas with a caseous necrosis, Jane cells, and lymphoepithelioid infiltrates, which are the hallmarks of Mycobacterium tuberculosis infection. Then, polymerase chain reaction of tuberculosis using the surgical specimen was done, and the diagnosis of retroperitoneal tuberculosis was established. There was no pulmonary or spinal involvement, and the patient was successfully treated with standard antitubercular therapy. Discussion. Retroperitoneal abscesses are often insidious and difficult to diagnose and cause a high rate of morbidity and mortality. The retroperitoneal infections can occur at various sites posterior to the peritoneum. These include four spaces: anterior retroperitoneal space, which includes esophagus, duodenum, pancreas, bile duct, portal and splenic veins, appendix, ascending and descending colon, and rectosigmoid. Posterior retroperitoneal space, which includes kidney, ureters, gonadal vessels, aorta, inferior vena cava, and lymph nodes. Retrofacial space, which includes palatal, spine, and paraspinous muscle. And pelvic retroperitoneal space, which includes prevesical, retrovesical, presacral, and perirectal spaces. Retroperitoneal abscess may complicate perforated colonic carcinoma, Crohn's disease of the bowel, diverticulitis, perforated appendicitis, or trauma. Other clinical conditions associated with the formation of retroperitoneal abscess include pyelonephritis, renal carbuncle, tuberculosis, trauma, and cancer. Abdominal tuberculosis is uncommon and generally seen in patients with severe disseminated disease. Our country is considered as an endemic area, and thus reactivation of latent infection should be considered even in an immunocompetent host. Delayed presentation and a large abscess formation like in our patient in cases of tuberculosis infection occur more frequently rather than in the cases of pyogenic infections. Tuberculosis may be detected by chest radiograph and abdominal computed tomography, which are the most frequently used imaging modalities, but there were no pathognomic criteria. And there are also no specific imaging techniques for retroperitoneal abscess secondary to tubercular infection. The polymerase chain reaction is rapid and a reliable test, and the results are available within 6.5 hours with a reasonable sensitivity and excellent specificity. Standard four-drug antitubercular therapy is the mainstay in the management of abdominal tuberculosis for at least 6 months. These are my references. Thank you.